learned this news in a letter issued by the Canadian Conference of Catholic Bishops. It was addressed to its dear Indigenous brothers and sisters. Father Thomas Rosica is the CEO of the Salt and Light Catholic Media Foundation. He's in Toronto. The letter says Pope Francis cannot personally apologize. So, Father Rosica, what does that mean? What's the rationale behind this?
Thanks very much, Andrew, for asking. I think what's underlying all of this, and perhaps some of the confusion coming from government officials, is the very nature of the church. Unlike other churches, which claim to have national churches in different countries, the church in Canada is a series of churches in each diocese. And over the past years, prior to the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, the diocese in which these residential schools took place, were held, were offering students their care, they have apologized repeatedly. So to expect the Pope to speak on behalf of all of those local churches is incorrect, and it doesn't understand the fundamental nature of the church. The Pope has taken very seriously the issue of Indigenous people around the world. Just, in fact, the past 3 years, 2015, someone mentioned a few moments ago, the Pope's visit to Bolivia, where he spoke to all Indigenous peoples around the world. And then in 2018, in January, we carried his visit to the Amazon, and we saw once again an effort to reach out. So to say that the Pope is not going to apologize is quite wrong. We're living in an age when apologies have become very cheap. Apologies, I'm sorry for this or for that, do not indicate a reconciliation has taken place. The Roman Catholic Church, the churches in Canada, have committed themselves to a very serious journey of reconciliation. When the Pope comes to a country, his visit is the crowning of all of those efforts of reconciliation. To say that the Pope will come and say, I'm sorry, then go back home, does not indicate a process has taken place.
Father Rosica, I understand your point, but there are people in this country who feel as though that apology is necessary and it's needed. And there have been other churches in this country that have apologized for their role.
You're absolutely right, Andrew.
The Anglican Church of Canada, for example.
But they're not the Catholic Church. The Catholic Church is structured in a different way.
So
if those people across the country have listened carefully to what's happened in the different dioceses over the years, and have read carefully the message of Pope Benedict in 2009 to Phil Fontaine, and repeated messages at individual meetings of popes with native leaders, they would understand that this is a journey and a process. So you can't compare us to the efforts of the United Church or the Anglican Church or other groups. It is a completely different reality.
Well, what about in January when Pope Francis apologized for the sexual abuse of minors perpetrated by priests in Chile?
The Pope was in Chile responding to a very specific situation. We're talking about an issue with the native community, so let's separate the issues. Pope Francis is deeply aware of the grave errors, sins, crimes committed in the name of the Catholic Church. And he has grappled with these from the beginning, and so has Pope Benedict. But Pope Francis is very free in speaking about them and addressing them, even willing to rethink, as we saw the situation in Chile with the bishop in Chile, to rethink what he originally thought and to issue a new investigation of the Chile situation.
I just don't see the difference with
There's
all respect.
There's a big difference,
I just
Andrew.
Don't see it.
Those who are Catholic, even those who are nominally Catholic, would understand there is a different thing. I think we have to be very careful in expecting apologies to solve every situation. Apologies can become very cheap.
It's just part of the process.
The other thing is, let me finish another thing. For a pope to come to a country, the pope comes at the request of the local churches, of the bishops. It is not the government who establishes the agenda of what the pope is going to do. No pope does that. The pope cooperates, collaborates respectfully of the governments, but the pope comes to visit the Catholics in that country, and he listens very carefully to the needs of the local churches expressed by the bishops. Last year, we had all of the bishops of Canada go through Rome through the ad limina visits, and I can assure you there were long discussions about the pros and the cons of whether or not this is the right moment. The pope has not said he will not come to Canada, and I can assure you, whether it be Pope Francis or his successor, when the Pope comes, the Indigenous people, the First Nations, will be very high on his priority list, as they have been under the visit of Pope, the visits of Pope John Paul II in 84 and 87, and of course the wonderful World Youth Day.
What would you say to those who are disappointed, never mind the Prime Minister, but to the indigenous people in this country, the residential school survivors?
I'm speaking with them.
I'm talking. Who want the Pope to apologize on behalf of the Catholic Church. He is the head of the Catholic Church.
I've talked to many of them. I've worked with them. I love them. And I've spoken to them, and many of them understand. Many of them are also frustrated with political maneuvering of using apologies that don't necessarily complete the reconciliation process. The process of the TRC was a process, a journey. It was very well thought out. I was part of it in the beginning. I've seen it. We've talked about it on our TV network. It is a journey, and it doesn't end. All of the churches in Canada, the diocese, the local churches, priests, pastors, lay people, leaders, sisters, are deeply committed to this. Some religious congregations, as you mentioned, the Oblates, the Jesuits, and others are deeply committed to it. Okay. So we're talking about a long-term commitment and not a cheapened apology.
All right. Father, appreciate you taking the time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Father Thomas Rosica in Toronto. He is the CEO of the Salt and Light Catholic Media Foundation.